Hey, welcome to Truman Tech Breaks. I'm Thomas, and today we're going to be talking about how to use Ivanti to install or update new software onto your Truman Windows machine. So again, just to kind of reiterate that, Ivanti is only available on primary Truman Windows machines. So this is going to be your desktop computer in your office or your laptop that is primarily assigned to you. This is not going to be in classrooms or on Macs or on your secondary lab machines, for instance. But yeah, if it is on your primary machine, then we should be good to go. So let's go ahead and take a look at some of the software that is available in Ivanti. We've got about 46 different pieces of software as of the recording of this video. And I'll go ahead and drop those into the description of this video too, just if you want to take a look at it later, but there they are. So yeah, let's go ahead and I'm going to go pull up a Windows desktop and we'll take a look at how we could either install or update this software. All right, so the first thing we're going to do here is go down to our Start menu in the bottom left-hand corner of the screen there. And in the list of programs, we'll scroll down to the eyes until we get to Ivanti Management. We'll click on that, and there's a couple of options available, but we're going to select Portal Manager. And we'll wait a couple seconds for it to come up. It'll take maybe 10, 15 seconds for the full list of software to populate here. But once it does, we'll be able to see all of the software that is available in Ivanti Portal Manager. So here you see I'm just kind of scrolling through to show you what the software looks like, and now you can find it in Ivanti Portal Manager. It is alphabetically arranged. You can see the name of the software as well as the version that is currently available within Ivanti. You also see that there is a install button underneath each of these. So I'm going to go ahead and click install on Zotero. Zotero is not yet on this machine, so I'm going to go ahead and put it on without needing any administrative credentials. So all I needed to do then was just click that, and you can see the process has already begun. Like any software, it does take a little bit of time to install. So I'm going to go ahead and kind of fast forward through this part real fast, and then we'll see what happens in the end. All right, and about 4 minutes later, we see that Zotero is just finishing up now and has now just appeared on our desktop. So we can go ahead and close out of Ivanti, click on Zotero, and begin using the software that we installed. And yeah, go ahead and explore Ivanti, see if there's anything that's useful to you, and you can go ahead and install it just as easily as this. All right, thanks everybody. Hope you have a great weekend, and we will see you later.